Welcome, welcome. Ciao. Today I have a surprise for you. I'm going to show you a comparison between the cyclone poles that MSR use for their Hubba Hubba line in the American market and the traditional aluminium poles that they use in Europe. If you're new here, my name is Davide, alaskatopatagonia.com, and I've started cycling the world in 2015, so you're in the right place if you're into bike traveling, bikepacking, camping, and the outdoor in general. So hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon so you're the first to know when I upload anything new. Vlogs, tutorials, review, and camping recipes in 3 languages. At the end of last summer, I published a review of the MSR Hubba, one-person tent. The Hubba Hubba, it's a two-person tent, and then a comparison between the two of them. And in those reviews, I mentioned that there are a few differences between the Hubba line on the American market and the one in the European market. One of the main differences, among others, is the poles. The poles that are used in the European market are the traditional aluminium poles, and in the American market they use the cyclone poles. They are a new type of poles that they are made with a composite materials. I don't know what the materials are. I'm guessing it's a fiber of some kind and some other secret ingredients that we don't know yet. And how do I have this? Is because a friend of mine was in the US, he bought the Hubba Hubba, and he came back and I asked him if he could borrow me the poles to do a comparison and to test them, and I was really curious to see how they were. He also told me that he was not going to use the tent in extreme weather condition, so if I was willing, he was willing to swap them for the aluminium poles. My tent was also relatively new, so my poles are in pristine condition. And at the beginning, I thought it was a bit strange that he would do this offer, because these are more advanced technology. But he told me that he preferred the aluminium ones. And to be honest, after I have them in my hand, I also think I prefer the aluminium ones. But let's go through. The main advantage of the cyclone poles is that they are extremely flexible. So you can basically bend them and they go back to their original shape. The aluminium is quite flexible, but at some point you bend them and they are just bended and they don't go back to their original shape. What does that mean? Practically, when we use our tent, is that we have to be careful when we are in very strong winds. If a wind is too strong, I'd say above 70, 80 kilometers per hour, 90 kilometers per hour, the wind is gonna flatten our tent, and the risk of damaging the aluminium poles is very high. These ones should not have this problem. They should be much more flexible. And I've seen a video of Easton, the company that makes the cyclone poles, that they basically threw winds of about 100 kilometers per hour to the tent and it goes back to normal. So I'm not gonna flatten my tent.
With the cyclone, we get a tent that's rigid but also flexible. So you can blow a cyclone tent down to the ground and it's gonna pop back up. We've never had that before in a tent frame, and it opens up a lot of different avenues for design and manufacturing.
But we will go through some of the main differences among those two. Basically, these ones are a little bit higher of a few centimeters when they're packed. They are also a little bit bigger because the hub are a bit bigger. And they are also a little heavier. They are about 70 grams heavier than the aluminium ones. The hubs are in plastic, and the hubs of the aluminium ones, they are in aluminium. Plastic is used all over. Even the tips, the feet of the poles, they are in plastic. They are not screwed on like the one in the aluminium poles, but they are just press fit with a little bit of glue, because I tried to remove it with a pliers. I was gentle, and I couldn't, and then I forced it a little bit, and then I noticed they put a little bit of glue there. And obviously you need to be able to remove them when you need to change the elastic, because at some point those elastic they become loose and you need to replace them. Another difference is that when you have them in your hand, those are very smooth, and those are smooth, but they are not as satisfying as the aluminium ones. Also, they tend to chip. So the fibers that are covering these poles, they kind of chip. So if I were to pass my hand on the tips, I would get like fibers in get stuck in my skin, and it's very difficult to remove them because they are very small and you cannot really see them. And the first time I was just feeling how smooth they were, and like a fiber went into my toe, and I had to take some tweezer and picking out loads of skin before I was able to remove the little fiber. So the fact that these fiber tend to come sort of loose, I'm not sure how to define it, it suggests me that there is some wearing while using the Cyclone poles. Now, I think they should outlast the normal life of a Hubba Hubba, that for intense usage, like if you cycle around the world and you use it intensely almost daily, you won't expect the tent to last more than 3 to 4 years maximum if you treat your tent very well. So for sure they are gonna outlast the tent, but I think there is a little bit of wearing that you don't find in the aluminium ones, unless you don't look after too well to the aluminium poles, and in that case they might start to crack where you insert them, because they snap into each other, or you don't fully insert them, and when you go and bend them when you pitch your tent, they might start to crack there. I met a few people that they cracked their tent poles. And obviously if you get into a huge storm, loads of wind, you can easily bend them, and then you're basically in some problems. Yeah, the MSR sell a splinter. They just, in case you bend a pole, you can insert the splinter, and you should be able to still pitch your tent. Now the tent is pitched, and I just wanted to show you that it does look a little bit more flexible than the aluminium one. I wouldn't dare to do things like this to the aluminium one, because I didn't want to bend them and permanently bend them. One of the things that I don't like about the Cyclone poles when you pitch the tent is that this hub here is basically one of the poles has to go till the end here, so it has to go inside, and sometimes it just stays there, and so you have to be careful that this pole has to go inside and till here. So I think that's all for the Cyclone poles. I had this opportunity to pick between the aluminium and the Cyclone poles, and I think I will pick the Cyclone poles, because resuming my round the world adventure, I will get to very windy places, so it will give me a little bit of extra peace of mind. And I will just probably wear my gloves when I pitch my tent, so that the fibers are not gonna get stuck in my hand, and I should be fine. I hope you find this video helpful, so hit the like button, subscribe if you haven't already. If you didn't find any value in this video, hit the dislike button twice, and I'll see you on the road. Ciao!